Look, my viewers always make fun of me for always traveling to America. So that's why I vlog traveling to America.
Lotto's losing his mind.
But look, I'm not just going to America to eat every single fast food. I have a purpose this time. First of all, I'm going to collect amazing vlog footage, as you saw here at the Streamer Games.
I'm at the Streamer Games. I've just signed up for my events. I don't think we're going to do that great, but I got this sick jersey. So that's one good plus.
I don't have a lot of faith,
but maybe we'll win. Let's see how it goes.
Dude, these are the nicest porta potties I've ever seen. Like, it's a nice toilet. It's got a nice ass sink.
It's a porta potty. What?
Yeah, I might have forgotten to vlog everything, but don't worry, because we did super well, as you can see on this leaderboard. But unlike me, you know what actually is good? The new 5.0 Genshin update. Now in Genshin, they added a bunch of new ways to traverse the world. And we're gonna try some of those, kind of, ourselves today. In this video, we're gonna be paragliding, we're gonna go rock climbing, and we're also gonna go e-foiling. And I'm not gonna lie, I'm pretty good at all of them. You already know everything there is to know about Genshin, but let me tell you what's new. Because in this new 5.0 update, you're gonna get 2 new 5 stars and a free 5 star character and free pulls. And they are also introducing massive rewards with a free 5 star standard banner character. And after the anniversary update, log in to receive 10 free pulls. And starting from August 28th, you will get additional rewards of 1600 primogens and a Fistborn Fire Sprite will be sent to you via email, which is 20 free pulls plus a free companion. Oh, what's that you want? More free pulls? Well, you're in luck because eligible players will also receive 10 free pulls through the Stellar Reunion system. And by completing the Liyue Archon quest, we'll immediately unlock the Natland storyline. So what are you waiting for? Jump in. What I'm basically trying to say is in the new 5.0 update, we are all eating good new content and tons of pulls. Get in on it. Smash that link in the description down below right now. Now let's return to our normal scheduled programming. And you know what? After that amazing performance at the Streamer Games, I wanted to become more American. So I asked Ludwig if we'd go and do the most American thing of all time, watch a baseball game. Now, I won't pretend to know much about baseball. This was my first time learning all the rules. It's a slow game, I'll tell you that much, but it was really fun and we had a bunch of food. The nachos were okay and the popcorn was mid at best, but it was very Moorish. But I will say, love the experience, 8 out of 10.
1-100, take it. I give you 100 right. To Homer.
He's not hitting a home run.
That's great for life.
That's a lifetime bet.
A lifetime bet.
Oh my God, his bat broke. Dude, his bat snapped off. What the hell?
He didn't get a home run.
Can I also just mention that I find it a little odd that in American sports, the crowd doesn't come up with the chants. There's just a giant speaker that goes, dun, 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 and then the crowd goes, oh, it's time. Dun, dun, dun. Instead of, you know, in Britain where we're like,
you're sh- and you know you're sh- you're sh-
like that, but a little more creative. Ludwig then also decided to take me to a British pub to do a pub quiz, which admittedly I do like. I just wish I had a teammate that, you know, was good at quizzes.
She is Blake Lively.
No idea. Yeah.
And I tried my best to carry the team, even getting some of the hard questions right, but look, you can't carry Ludwig. And after recovering from a terrible pop quiz, I ended up spawning in San Diego. And this hotel just had a very long hallway. But I have to say, congratulations, San Diego. As a British person, I was amazed at what sun can look like. This place was really stunning.
We are here. Everyone is here. It looks awesome. Getting ready. Oh my God, the fly went by my head. Also, oh my God, it's like a TV show. Just shirtless dudes running around.
The main purpose of today is to complete 3 challenges, each focusing on a different method of traversal. So the first is a water challenge featuring e-foiling, which is kind of like surfing, but kind of cooler. It's like a normal surfboard, except they just took a rudder off a boat and stuck it on, and then added a controller that allows you to speed up. So basically nothing like surfing, but I will say this was really cool. And the challenge was to go all the way out to a platform, grab a key, bring it back and solve the puzzle, which we were not very good at. But luckily, and I didn't get this on camera, I don't think, but the instructor said I was the best at e-foiling in the group. I just want to have that on the record because I didn't win much else in this vlog. Next up was paragliding. I've never done it. It seems pretty dangerous. I did try to do it around a year ago, but was told I was too caked up, shall we say. And on the start of the day, we were actually told that me and Ludwig were the only ones who were too heavy to fly. Look, being caked up has its drawbacks, okay? But then, just as we were about to give up hope, we were told the wind was strong enough to lift our fat asses into the clouds. And so, we got to paraglide. And I gotta say, it was really cool. So cool, in fact, that I completely forgot about the challenge and I did not help my teammates at all. In fact, I actually just started taunting them and telling them how much fun I was having. But I mean, look at some of these views. These views are incredible. And could you imagine doing this in like the UK? It'd be like, oh good, we get to go up to the sky to look down at how gray everything is. Oh, what a great patch of seaweed. Oh, look at that, the seagull vomited. And I hate to admit it, San Diego, but what a stunning place. All right, Americans, you have us beat there. And in a lot of other places as well. Don't worry about it. And also, I'm so sorry. I'm sure some of you noticed. Yes, my pee-pee is being crushed with the force of Zeus and I can no longer have children.
Here we go. We're gonna do a hard left. We're gonna spiral down here. We're gonna go around more than one.
That is awesome. That is such a good move.
I love that.
Wow, you can learn anything on YouTube.
Oh, it's amazing.
What do you think? High five? Okay, high five. Oh my god!
That is f***ed up! That's f***ed up!
The look at his face is hilarious!
And you can kind of make out what happened there for a quick second, but basically the instructors both hit their gliders together. I did not like that! But I have to say, paragliding, one of the coolest things I've ever done.
Coming in hot! Did I do it? Not bad for my second one, huh?
Oh, man.
And I don't think a British man has gotten this much sun ever. But next up was rock climbing. I've done a fair amount of rock climbing. I'm by no means the greatest, but my lord, these walls were so hard. I tried one of their easy ones and I was really struggling. But luckily for us, for the challenge, they'd set up some extra easy ones that were super beginner friendly. And luckily, we completed the challenge with zero issues. Now, if you've watched my main channel, you'll know I love trains. And I love fancy trains, I love bougie trains, just an experience overall. And when Ludwig told me we could ride an American train back to LA, well, I wasn't thrilled. American public transport doesn't have the best reputation, but it was okay because we'd get a business class seat, which I'm sure is good. So immediately when getting on the train, I gunned for the toilet. And I have to say, oh.
Floor is, well, disgusting. To say the least, it's pretty filthy. It looks vile.
The sink is great. It's just like being back in prison. We have the most depressing looking toilet. But look at this. This has seen some shit.
They got a toilet seat cover at least, that's nice. Very considerate.
You know, overall, I have to say,
it's like a 2 out of 10. It's not it. It's a toilet, let's be honest. But it does the job. So now I'm gonna piss.
Luckily for us, our free business class seat comes with a free cafe, or whatever you'd call this.
Ah, welcome to our kitchen. Can I interest you in some hot coffee?
How long do you reckon it's been there for?
Wow.
I'll try a little bit. Oh, that's like 1 million degrees. Let's just give it a little sippy. No, that's bad.
Then they have some pastries, which are apparently freshly made. Blueberry. We've got, ooh.
Those look great.
Ew. I'm not gonna lie. Pineapple cream cheese.
Okay, that's a little crazy. I won't lie.
What is pineapple cream cheese? That sounds horrific. And then we decided to take a stroll through the train to see what the rest of it looked like. I'm not sure why there's a reserve tape going over this like some kind of crime scene, but hey. American trains. The economy class seemed pretty much identical to the business class. In fact, I'd even argue that the economy area had a few benefits, like being closer to the food. Speaking of food, what do you think food is like on an American train? Well, I was wondering the same thing, so we ordered as many things as we could. They have burgers, hot dogs called Hebrew National, some vegetable stuff, and tamales? Anyway, here's our haul.
So we got a burger.
Let's start with the hot dog.
Check it out. Like you spread your condiment.
You spread that so bad.
And then like, okay. To not make a mess.
No.
Throw it away. You want double ketchup?
Yeah, a little bit more.
You want wiener cider?
You go for whatever you feel
comfortable. His or hers?
His. I'll go with his. Oh, no.
Let's get this dog a bite. Let's unleash the double. It's roasting.
The bun is horrible because it's microwaved.
Yeah, the dog is not bad.
No, it's a Hebrew national.
Next up was the burger. And I won't lie, not very appetizing, but surprisingly, not bad.
You know, I want to hate it so much. It's not as bad as it looks.
The bun has the same problem.
Yeah.
Where it's microwave, so it kind of like has a styrofoam
the
texture.
Cheese is kind of good.
The cheese is
the
great.
The cheese is yummy.
And the burger's like fine.
The cheese is yummy.
It really wasn't that bad. Why is a microwave burger not that bad? Probably a lot of just salt and preservatives making it kind of decent. Next up, we had the tamales. I've actually never had a tamale, and I think this is a terrible way of getting introduced to them.
Take a little bite.
This was probably the worst thing I've ever put in my mouth. And I put a lot of bad things in my mouth. And whilst the food wasn't great, the view was pretty amazing. Moving on to something you most certainly can't mess up, a cup ramen. Obviously, Ludwig and I liked it. It's literally a cup ramen. It's hard to mess up. However, I will say it is probably the weakest broth flavor I've ever had in a ramen. I feel like a crumb of Indomie has more flavor than this entire thing. But luckily for me, the cookie, the cookie was fire!
That's excellent. That's fantastic.
Amazing.
Overall, I gotta say, it's pretty but hey, for America, it's not bad.
And cheap.
I was pleasantly surprised by American Trains. Going in, I thought it was going to be a hellscape that was uninhabitable and had nothing to offer. And I left just feeling like, it's just pretty bad. So that's good. It does remind me a little bit of some of the worst trains that we had in the UK where it was basically just a free-for-all. And obviously living in Japan, I've been spoiled with amazing trains. So it's kind of hard to go back to any other country and go on their trains. And before I knew it, I had to fly back to Japan. I honestly had so much fun. Let me know if you enjoyed this vlog and if you want more content like this. I would be very happy to oblige. I just forget to film a lot. But I hope you had fun. If you want to go and watch the full original video, go to Twanto's channel to see all of the challenges in full. And, well, watch me and Ludwig not do great in them. And make sure to subscribe if you haven't already, because we're always doing interesting stuff on this channel. And if you want to, you can come watch me live on twitch.tv/COVA. We're live 3 or 4 times a week. And a massive thank you to Genshin for sponsoring this vlog and making sure I could go and do all these cool stuff. Go and check out the update in the description down below right now. Bye.